Hey everybody, so I'm back to do a first impression review on the new Revlon Colorstay 2-in-1 Foundation and Concealer. I have a little problem with this video because I did record this already with the wear test and all, and sadly, the application clip, my mic was not on. That was my bad, so I'm redoing the application clip for you guys so I can kind of talk from a I did this already standpoint. But the wear test and the pictures as far as like starting point, ending point will still be from the original like recording date, which shouldn't really throw anything off to be honest because it's pretty accurate. So to talk about this product a little bit, I got it at Bed Bath & Beyond because they always get the new releases first for me, and it was around I think $13, around like $12.99, and I got shade 200 Nude. I broke my own rule for once, which is usually if there is a shade called Natural Beige to go with that shade. I went with the shade above Natural Beige, which looked a little bit more yellow because they look really dark in the pan. So it's a compact with concealer, and when you lift the concealer, there is a foundation underneath, and underneath that, if you can carefully pick it up without sticking your finger in it, there's a mirror and a teardrop application puff. And as you can see, I did try the puff out, and honestly, it sucks. Damp or dry, don't use it. It doesn't work very well. I wouldn't try it unless you're in like a dire touch-up situation. I would use a damp beauty blender, ideally as the applicator. It's okay with a brush, but honestly, it applies better with a sponge. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that for you guys right now. The shade will look a little light on camera, especially on my forehead, because of course your forehead is like the darkest part of your head, or face, dark part of your head. But as far as winter goes, I think Natural Beige would have been a little too tan. This was a little bit more yellow, so I'm kind of happy with going with the shade. It's not perfect per se, and a little con I had was that you can't pick what concealer shade you get. It's, you know, obviously preset, so that's a little downside about it. It gets a little messy in the pan as well. It's really easy to get it just generally all over the place, but it's pretty easy to blend out. As you can see, it kind of starts looking a little light until you blend it in and let it set. I also set it with a powder that's a little darker than my face to bounce it out, and it looks perfectly fine, as you'll see later on when I have like my bronzer on and all that. But it will look a little light at first because it is a little light, like I said, but it's not impossible to work with. If you want to go with something that's a little darker, definitely go with Natural Beige if we're usually around the similar like shade selections, which I'll have down below if you need other shades to compare with. It's pretty easy and fast to apply. That I like about it. And it has a good amount of coverage just as the foundation. The three claims are that it is all day wear, a flawless finish, and it's supposed to be sweat resistant. Now for the concealer, I also think applying it with a sponge is kinda ideal, but it's really hard to pick up with a sponge, honestly. Like, you really have to like dig it into the concealer and then go back and forth with it because it sets super fast. Both of these products set super fast, so like really get in there and apply it as fast as you can because otherwise it's gonna look kinda drier. And I just apply the concealer under my eyes because it is like a lighter concealer than the foundation, so it does cover pretty well. As far as coverage goes, I think the foundation is a really nice medium, and then the concealer is also a good medium. I wouldn't say it's a super full coverage concealer, but it gives you enough. Like, this is not bad for everyday, or even if you applied it heavier for going out. As you can see, it definitely brightens everything up. If you have oily skin, I do suggest to wear a powder with it because it is not a flat matte finish. It's kind of like a semi matte. It's not dewy at all, but my sponge just fell. It is still kind of reflective, especially where the concealer is. So I'm gonna set my face. You can see a picture from the first wear test where it's just the foundation, and then I also take a picture with this powder, which I use my Velvet Beauty brush and my Maybelline Matte and Poreless powder. And I just dabbed it all over. It's a shade 210, if you're wondering. And if you want to set your concealer with like a lighter yellow powder, feel free to do so. So now that we have our foundation and our powder on, I will give you the foundation powder picture as well as the starting point before the ending clip of this wear test. I apologize that it's not all the same day. This rarely happens. I would reshoot it, but honestly, I think it's just more time productive to just show you guys the original wear test, because I would be able to wear it longer that day, or I was able to wear it longer than I will be able to today. So I hope you guys enjoy it regardless. Thank you guys as always for watching. I have so many new drugstore reviews coming up, so stay tuned for the rest of the wear test, and I'll say bye to you guys again at the end of this video. So it's been a total of about 6 hours going on to 7, and it's like the final checkup. So I have taken my pictures, and you can see that it is getting shiny in the usual areas that I get oily, which is next to my nose and the center of my forehead, which I did not put on any highlighter like right here really much at all. I mean, I have highlighter on my cheeks and it's really subtle. So the area that's starting to get a little tacky is starting to get oily. But it's not horrible. It's definitely like not like removing the foundation or anything like that. I think if you just keep a powder around, if you have oily skin and touch up, it should be fine. The shade definitely worked out perfectly fine with my body and neck. I feel like the other one definitely would have been darker because I do have bronzer and such on now. I have a little blemish showing through. I apologize. Otherwise, I mean, it looks fine. It definitely has a similar finish to Revlon Colors Day, if anything. Like, it has that look to it. It doesn't get into my pores. I'm wearing it without primer, and my nose area and everything still looks good. All in all, it's not bad. It's starting to feel a little heavy though compared to when it was first applied. It definitely feels heavier than like most liquid foundations, but not heavier than Revlon Colors Day, because to me Revlon Colors Day feels really, really heavy because it's super full coverage. But this one's like a lighter version of it with the same benefits. So all in all, I still like it. I just realized that this technically is Revlon Colors Day, but you guys get what I'm saying. The liquid foundation versus the cream one. I definitely like this better. As far as the concealer goes, it hasn't creased on me at all. I set it with my usual like highlight powder, and it hasn't creased or transferred. It's starting to come off a little bit on the blemish that I have right here, like the little scar. But otherwise, everything else, it's still fine. It's still covered. I don't like the fact that you really can't pick what shade you want in the concealer compared to like if you wanted a lighter one than what came with your foundation. And it is a little tough to work with as far as how fast it sets. Claim-wise for the foundation, was it all day wear? I think it wears well. Was it a flawless finish? Definitely. Is it sweat resistant? I didn't sweat that much, I'll be honest. It's kind of like December, so I'm not really sweating that much. But I think it held up pretty well, so I'll give it a check mark for that one too. No real complaints aside from the whole you can't really pick your shade and it being a little harder to work with. I think there's a decent amount of shades. It's a decent price. And the concept is great. The applicator honestly sucks. So if you just keep your own beauty blender around you, I think you'd be way better off. But it does kind of take the convenience factor out of it. If you have drier skin, I think this would be great for on the go because you wouldn't need a powder to set it with. But if you're oily, you can still make it work for you. Because without primer, I'm actually very impressed with how it looks on my face. So all in all, I guess I could say it's kind of approved. I'm not like head over heels in love holy grail status, but it's a good new release for sure. So that's about it. Thank you guys as always for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed seeing this first impression review of the new Revlon Colors Day 2-in-1 makeup foundation and concealer. Please comment, rate, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in a later video.